Hello, my name is Miłosz Kosobucki and I work for KDAB. This is the second video in our series about working with C++ Qt applications on Windows Subsystem for Linux, or WSL. If you haven't seen the previous video, you will find the link in the description below. Today, I would like to tell you how to work with WSL from Visual Studio Code that is running directly on your host operating system. It's a much more streamlined experience than working from IDE that is running inside WSL. Let's get started. I'm assuming that you already installed WSL and configured it as shown in our previous video. If not, please do it right now. I'm also assuming that you have Visual Studio Code installed on your host operating system. Okay, we can now start Visual Studio Code. And first thing we need to do is to install the WSL extension because it's not there by default. So let's go to the extension tab and search for WSL and install the extension. Now that it is installed, we can use the button and the bottom left corner of the screen and select connect to WSL. If you have more than one WSL distribution installed, you can choose it here. But we will connect to the default one. Our VS Code is now in a remote mode, which means that we only see a graphical UI that is actually operating a Visual Studio Code instance inside the WSL. It's completely separate thing. You didn't need to install anything inside WSL because it happens automatically. But we don't have necessary extensions here because, as I said, it's a completely separate instance. To configure and compile C++ projects, we need some extensions. So let's go to the extension tab and install the C++ extension for working with C++ projects. And CMake extension for working with CMake build system, the one from Microsoft. We now have all necessary tools to develop our application. We can now open our project, so let's go to File, Open Folder, and as you can see, we don't have a regular Windows file picker here because we are not browsing a local file system, but the remote one through the WSL connection. So let's choose our folder. Okay. And we are asked to configure the project with CMake. So let's try that. And we're getting an error because CMake cannot find our Qt. We haven't specified where to look for it. So to do that, the easiest way is to tell the CMake extension that it should set certain CMake variable when it does the configuration. We can do this by creating a .vscode folder with settings.json file. And inside this file, we need to tell CMake where to look for Qt. I prepared a configuration for that. So we tell the extension that the configure settings are that we need to set the CMake prefix path variable to this path where our Qt is installed. So let's save that. And now we're ready to try building again here. And this time we succeed because Qt was found by CMake. We can try running the application with the play button. And indeed, it starts. Similar to Qt Creator that we ran in the previous video, we see the application window. It's running inside WSL, but it shows up on our Windows machine. We also see the console output. We can also use the debugger the same way as we did in Qt Creator So let's set a breakpoint here and press this small bug button to run it under the debugger. And again, if we click the button, the application stops and we can inspect the variables as you would expect from a debugger session. There is one last trick I would like to show you about working with VS Code under WSL. So let's stop the debugger session. If you often have to switch between VS Code running on your host OS and the one running in WSL, you may get confused which one you're looking at. What we can do is to make the colors of the one we're running under WSL different. To do that, while we are in the remote session, we can go to File, Preferences, Settings, and if we choose the remote WSL tab here and go to Workbench Appearance, we can set different color theme, say solarized light, that will be set only for the WSL connection. If I then disconnect, I get my other theme. Now if I connect again, it turns to the bright theme. This way you can easily distinguish which VS Code instance you are running. Today we learned how to use Visual Studio Code running on your host OS to develop and test applications inside WSL. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to learn more about tools around C++ and Qt, make sure to subscribe to our channel. If you have any questions, use the comments section below. Do widzenia!